Well, joining me this evening is Nupur Sharma, spokesperson of the BJP. Also with me this evening is Riju Datta of the Trinamool Congress, the man of the moment representing his party, Suman Sriraman, Dr. Suman Sriraman, political analyst. We also have Ghanshyam Tiwari, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Anand Ranganathan, author. Joining us in just a bit would be Yashwant Deshmukh, our resident cephologist from Seawater, who put out that survey, which was possibly the closest survey as far as the results are concerned. Of course, everybody was off the mark, but clearly, in terms of the BJP's numbers, Yashwant Deshmukh can take the credit for getting the direction absolutely right. And let me ask you, Nupur Sharma, today is a tough day for the BJP to reconcile. It's been a fantastic growth of the BJP. Make no mistake about that. 3 to 78 is not a small feat. But I'm asking you, was the 200 seats mark rhetoric? Was it an overestimation? Have you now really accepted the fact that Jai Shri Ram has an antidote in Chandipat? Do you believe that in the Hindutva regions, out of the 46 seats, Mamata Banerjee's party has won 40 of them in this Hindi-speaking belt, which you were targeting? The Matua card, which the BJP was talking about, 80% of those 81 seats also won by the Trinamool Congress. Nupur Sharma, why was there so much of a difference in the estimation of the BJP and the actual results?
Well, Navika, good evening to you. And I would first like to start by congratulating the TMC for their victory. But, you know, I was hearing the political campaigner, the strategist for the TMC, and there's some general observations that you would please allow me some 40 seconds to please complete. You know, I honestly believe that it is unwarranted absolutely to attack a constitutional authority like the Election Commission. I'm no spokesperson for the EC, but as a lawyer and as a concerned citizen of this country, I would have to point out the hypocrisy of taking what you like and rejecting what you don't like. Well, the results of all other 200 plus seats is acceptable to you, not of Nandigram. Well, the facts and the hypocrisy hidden behind how you're blaming everybody else of polarizing, but you obviously ignore the call for all Muslims to vote or block by Mamata Didi, that you would ignore. Of course, there was also observation made about, you know, narratives in the air. Well, you know, the Didi ki Sawari wheelchair miraculously escaped from underneath her after 2 months, and today she's walking fit and fine. And whatever happened to a counter-narrative being attempted to be set of doing Chandipath and temple tourism? So the observations of we didn't try to do all this, we only did this, and sorry, every attempt was also made at narrative building. The hypocrisy behind attacking EC, EVMs, and the entire paraphernalia of, the entire procedure and process undertaken by the Election Commission in taking what you like, dismissing what you do not like. Well, if you're challenging Nandigram, might as well challenge all the 200 plus seats. And also saying that you were polarizing, we weren't. Well, the Honorable Calcutta High Court pulled you up for a minority appeasement 6 times over. As far as the BJP is concerned, you know, the observations you've made are correct. We will wait for the final numbers because we do know that 100 plus seats are on very close margins. And we can see a 2.5-3% dip in our vote share from 2019. Now, whether that 2.5-3% is the reason why there's such a small margin in those 100 seats, what was the reason? Was the reason that we could not galvanize and mobilize our cadres to pull out our voters at the nick of time? Was it corona pandemic or was it something else? It's something that we'll only be able to assess later on. But at the end of it, I'm going to say this much and end. Yes, TMC won. Yes, Mamata Didi is a formidable leader. We never contested that. But jo apne ghar mein, apne gadh mein, apne backyard mein, apne bastion mein, apni seat nahi nikal pa raha, uske rajnitik kendriya mahatvakankshaye kitni safal rahengi, prabal rahengi, that is a big question.
Well, उन्होंने कितनी बार अपनी नेशनल पॉलिटिक्स की चिंता जताई है? कभी भी नहीं नुपुर शर्मा. सो दैट इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ एन अनफेयर अटैक ऑन ममता बैनर्जी. शी इज ऑलवेज फॉट फॉर बंगाल एंड दैट्स व्हाट शी सेड शी वुड डू एंड शी इज डन दैट. एंड एज प्रशांत किशोर सेड, एज द तृणमूल कांग्रेस हैज सेड, शी इट वॉज हर नेम ऑन विच द अदर 200 plus seats वर ऑल्सो वन. सो येस, Nandigram is a big message. Nandigram is a big victory for Shubhendu Adhikari. It was his stronghold and the BJP probably chose the best candidate and made the best candidate of the Trinamool Congress defect to them. I'm not taking that, political strategic thinking away from the BJP. But the fact is to say that just because apne ghar mein wo haar gayi hain or that's why nothing in Bengal matters would be rather unfair. What do you think, Riju Datta?
First of all, Navika ji, a very, very good evening. And today, as you can understand, I'm absolutely, happy and tired at the same time. But first of all, my salute to the genius called Prashant
Kishore. But it must be a very satisfied fatigue, because congratulations to you for winning. And it must be a very satisfied fatigue that you are feeling.
Of course. Absolutely, Navika ji. And I've been on your shows multiple times shouting the fact that Didi will win Bengal and she'll win big. And the way she has won, it was unprecedented. And I will be the first person to raise my hand and say that even I never dreamt that we will get 216 or 214. So it is unprecedented landslide victory. But I will make certain points. This is the mandate of the people of Bengal. And certain things have been made very clear today. First, there is no anti-incumbency against Mamata Banerjee. Second, communal politics is not welcome in Bengal. Third, the narrative of cut money, tola baji, blaming a certain person by all and imposing all the state machineries on him has fallen flat, because simply the people of Bengal did not trust BJP of whatever their narrative was. And fifth, that all the turncoats, 90% of them, who did so-called gaddari with Mamata Banerjee were rejected by the people of Bengal. And I will say that, going forward, it's a big message that the duo of the formidable duo of Modi ji and Shah and the election machinery of BJP, they can be defeated, and they can be defeated badly if you know your strategies. And lastly, after hearing my friend, I call her my friend because we have been on multiple debates, Nupur's statement and the way she was ranting, I will probably send a box of Bernal to 6A Dindal Upadhyay Marg. That's all I have to say.
What do you want me to send you for Nandigram?
Well.
What do you want me to send you for Nandigram? I never said, by the way, Avika, One second, Riju. I never said she's not big in West Bengal. But the fact that all opposition leaders rushed to West Bengal and are hailing here as the next big challenger to Modi, my observation was simply on that. Can she be a challenger if she cannot win an election in her own state?
For that matter,
we were not the incumbent, Riju. We were not the incumbent in West Bengal. We were at 3 seats with 10% vote share. We grew 4 times. Please have that correct. We only grew. We had nothing to lose at the start.
So let's open this up.
Navika, 10 seconds. 10 seconds. Okay.
Bolo, Dada.
If you would give me a chance, Navika ji, I'll just take 10 seconds. 10 seconds. In 2016, we had 211 seats. CPM had 75 seats. BJP had 3. Now, CPM is 0, BJP is 77. So basically, BJP is the new CPM of West Bengal. So with all due respect, even they have grown from 3 to 77, it is nothing much to clap about. That's all.
Even TMC was the erstwhile CPM. What? Do your homework on the history of TMC, how TMC was formed and founded.
Well, but you will have to admit, Nupur Sharma, and let me get in Dr. Suman Sriraman and Anand Ranganathan on the show. Suman Sriraman, the defectors have sunk the BJP. Rajiv Banerjee losing, Jitendra Tiwari losing, Sabyasachi Datta trailing. These are the so-called jumping of the ship that had been done, the turncoats gallery. And then look at the MPs. There is Lockheed Chatterjee. She lost. There is also my friend Babul Supriyo, who lost from his seat. So clearly the big names in the BJP didn't quite make it.
We have to give Mamata Banerjee full credit for having pulled off a spectacular victory. I mean, spectacular is the only word for it, because I don't think, anyone expected them to go beyond 200, you know. So, and the exit polls were completely off the mark, way, way off the mark. So I think first of all, to hand it to her, she is the person of the match. There is no doubt. What happened in Nandigram is basically quite inconsequential, because at the end of the day, she has two options. One is to contest in one of the seats where the candidates passed away, unfortunately, due to COVID, where the elections were not could not be held. Or simply get sworn in as chief minister and merely contest by-election within the next 6 months. So materially, it actually makes no difference, and it does not significantly take away from the sheen of the victory of the Trinamool Congress. Second, I mean, whichever way you look at it and whichever way you want to spin it, Navika, this is a big setback for the BJP. It would not have been a big setback had the Prime Minister and the Home Minister not invested so much of time, effort and energy. If this had been just treated like just another assembly election, then yes, the BJP could say, look,
I can't quarrel with you on that, but let me get in Dr. Anand Ranganathan. Dr. Anand Ranganathan, do you agree with Dr. Suman Sriraman?
Yeah, good evening, Navika. No, first of all, heartiest congratulations to BV and to TMC and also to Rijuda for this fantastic victory, even though Didi lost herself, but even in her losing, she has shown that only TMC can defeat TMC. But, you know, Navika, and congratulations to BJP for Assam and for Pondicherry and to DMK for Tamil Nadu and everyone who won, and commiserations to people who lost. But Navika, if I can be very honest with you, today is yet another bleak day that has ticked away, and we await yet another bleak day. And the point of the matter is that no matter, there are people celebrating, well-deserved, but there are people who've lost their lives for what is rapidly turning out to be a man-made disaster. So, and especially because I have so many erudite co-panelists who are going to analyze these elections much better than I can, with your permission, can I take maybe less than a minute to talk about COVID? Because that is what is troubling, and maybe a couple of things that are important as far as COVID is concerned.
Absolutely. Go ahead, Anand Ranganathan.
Yeah, thank you very much. Navika, very quickly, two issues, looking at the situation today and the fact that Delhi and most of the hospitals in Delhi, at least half a dozen of them, have been crying for oxygen and not getting it. Two issues. Number one, I think we have to accept this fact that we have lost the race as far as saving lives as quickly as possible through vaccination. I'm looking at the dashboard tonight, and we have vaccinated first dose only 0.3 million people today. Yesterday, we vaccinated only 0.7 million first dose. So in the last 2 days, we have managed to vaccinate, even though our vaccination capacity Delhi is 6 to 7 million doses, we are vaccinating only 1 million people per day. So I think we can set that aside. What is the other solution to save lives as quickly as possible? And it is through oxygen. And here is the tragedy that is rapidly unfolding. And I think one absolute fast solution would be that center should relinquish its control
It is true, but I have breaking news. I have breaking news coming in. Shuvendu Adhikari's convoy has been attacked in Haldia. That's the latest information we are getting. Well, we have seen some violence earlier today as well. BJP's office being burned down. Now Shuvendu Adhikari's convoy being attacked. Well, we just hope that Mamata Banerjee can send a message to her cadres that yes, it's a big victory. And Riju Datta, I'm sure nobody in the Trinamool Congress will support this kind of violence. Not necessary when you're the victor, entire confrontation of the campaign is behind us. You are the victors, and there has to be grace in this. And I hope the appeal will go out to the cadres of the Trinamool Congress not to resort to violence. But let me get in the man of the match right here on Times Now, Yashwant Deshmukh. Yashwant Deshmukh, well, let me congratulate you and congratulate you here on the News Hour for getting your numbers absolutely closest to what the results were. The direction was right. The fact that Mamata Banerjee will get a majority was right. Possibly the lowest numbers that were given to the BJP were by ETG and the C voter. And Yashwant Deshmukh, 115 seats is what you had given. 77 is what it's showing right now. What do you read into these results that are coming in today?
Well, two major things. You know, whatever the trends we had spotted, they have consolidated further in that direction. One, that we said that very clearly, there is no division in Muslim votes in Bengal as far as the hyper-analyzed issue of Muslims getting divided was concerned. There was no division. In fact, so much so that even in the Murshidabad, Malda belt, where, you know, Congress and left had the traditional stronghold seats, concentrated pockets of Muslim-dominated seats with them. Even in those seats, those voters have shifted lock, stock and barrel to the TMC. So that is the biggest thing, that there was no division. In fact, it was a much more consolidated vote by the Muslims in West Bengal, number one. Number two, the biggest one, I would say, as the X factor of these elections across India, Navika, is basically the emergence of women voters as an independent vote bank. You know, each and every victor has to say thank only and only to women voter in that particular state. Mamata can never win only on the Muslim votes in West Bengal. It was the women votes which largely came out in big numbers and voted for Mamata Banerjee purely because of the issues that are concerned with day-to-day life rather than the emotive issues and the communal polarization. Same thing has happened in Assam. BJP could win Assam only because of the female votes. So is the case with the left front in Kerala. The left could win again only because of the female votes on the performance, on the governance, the issues which matter on day-to-day things. Well, and the same is true about Tamil Nadu also, Navika.
Well, Yashwant Deshmukh, what you're saying is the Muslims voted for her, the Hindi-speaking voted for her, the Matuas voted for her, the women voted for her. It was really Mamata Banerjee all the way. Yes, the BJP has posted a spectacular increase in its vote share, but it is a little bit of a come down from what it was in the 2019 Lok Sabha elections. Clearly, that time Modi was the face and people voted for him, had trusted him. In the state elections, well, not so much. I know I'm being unfair to you, Ghanshyam Tiwari, because I'm completely out of time. But I want to ask you just one question. Now, for the opposition alliance, whether at the center or, you know, in the parliament, not really for the political stakes, but just for being an opposition against the ruling BJP at the center, do you think Mamata Banerjee has proved her mettle and she's going to be the new icon?
Mamata Banerjee and every party leader who has won, NK Stalin, the BJP in Assam, the leaders in Puducherry, and the leaders in Kerala. Two, it is absolutely clear that BJP needs a new party president, and who better than the Prime Minister himself, because India needs a new Prime Minister. We need somebody who can focus on the battle of COVID and not focus on his own party. And
Well, Ghanshyam Tiwari. Well, Ghanshyam Tiwari, we'll debate on that prognosis maybe on another day. I said I apologize to you for the very little time that I could give you. But thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me on this special edition of the News Hour on a Sunday, on election day, and on a day that we've seen some very grim numbers on COVID coming in. Yes, congratulations to all the parties and their leaders who won the elections. But at the same time, it is important that violence be controlled in Bengal. And it is important for each one of us to look at how to keep ourselves safe, our families safe, and follow COVID appropriate behavior. Thank you and good night.